Hey everyone, so this video I am going to explain you about the architecture of the user authentication service that we are going to create. So this service is going to be very important from the perspective of the security, and this is going to be the centralized service where we are going to store the user information, and all the services around the online shopping portal are going to connect to this user auth service to get the user information. Okay, so this short video I'm just going to explain the architecture what we are going to cover here. Okay, so let's go ahead and see this. So this is what user auth service is here, and there are a couple of endpoints that I'm going to create here. So first one, it is going to be the user registration, and user registration is going to contain the name, password, email, mobile number, role, what role it has, and the verification. Verification means what admin user, general user, or any other user is there. So we are going to create the verification endpoint as well. So the second endpoint is going to be the user verification. So while creating the user, while registering the user, we are going to create a unique token to verify the user for each role. User verification endpoint is going to take the email and token. Token means that unique code which is going to verify the user for a specific role. And third endpoint is we are going to find the user by the email. If you find, if you see that email, you can get that information about the user. And the other endpoints that we are going to use is the token generation. This is going to be the very important part here. So this is where we have created the user. Now user is trying to access to other endpoints. I do not want to pass the direct username and password. I want to generate the tokens. This is going to help us in doing that. User is going to pass the email and password, then it will get the token. That token it can use to access the other services. And while other services are going to verify, other services are getting the token from the user, they need to. And while other services have got the token, they need to verify that. So that token verification is going to happen with this endpoint here. Okay. So this is the general diagram. This is the general general structure of the user auth service, that what it is going to look like. And these are the couple of endpoints here. So what from technology perspective, what we are going to use? Spring Boot, obviously we are going to use that. To store the user information, we are going to use the MySQL. And Spring Security, to secure the application, this is what we are going to use. OAuth server, we are going to implement that. JWT, JSON Web Token, I'm going to explain all about it, what is this all about in the further videos. And after creating the entire services here, I'm going to explain you how to write the unit and integration test. Unit test is going to be the common because we just focus on the specific method that we are testing. But integration testing of this service is going to be interesting because we have a Spring Security in place here. So this is going to be interesting. And then finally, when we have this service ready, we are going to register this Spring Boot and this user authentication service with the Spring Boot admin server to monitor this Spring Boot, to monitor this user authentication service. All right, so if you have if you are watching the previous videos, if you have watched that one, you know how to create the Spring Boot admin server, how effective, how important this to have this monitoring application. All right, so that's all about this video. I wanted to cover the brief what it is going to look like, user authentication service. So I'll see in the next video with the actual coding and demo part of the user auth service.